Hey guys, it's Celestia, and today I'm going to be talking about an issue that a recent event on TikTok has brought to light. Actually, let's be honest here, calling it an event on TikTok is generous. An artist got cancelled for a minor issue that the community decided was heinous enough to warrant them climbing onto their high horses to fight against for, what, the millionth time this week? And if it was something as stupid as the whole art style theft argument, I wouldn't bother making a video about it at all, because it's hard to stretch, you can't steal an art style, nothing is inherently original, everything's inspired by something else, stop acting like your self-proclaimed moral superiority means that the fake problems you invent and blame others for have any credence, into a 10-minute video. But this particular TikTok show does actually have an interesting, valid basis that's worth discussing, even if I don't think the way people went about addressing it was right. So, I'm not going into depth about the drama that prompted this debate because, number one, that's not what I do here, and number two, Ethan Becker already did it way better than I ever could in the video shown in the card above, so go watch that if you want the actual details. All you need to know to understand this video's topic is that an artist on TikTok posted a video of her drawing Britney Spears, and because she has an exaggerated style of art, Britney's waist was significantly thinner than it could really be. That's it. That's all it took for the feral crowd of pitchfork-wielding maniacs to start harassing and insulting her with the fury of a thousand suns. Because that's not stylized art, it's erasing real body types and body diversity, so she doesn't have the right to draw it, and she should apparently be dragged through the mud for ever assuming otherwise. Now, in her interview with Ethan Becker, Jackie, the artist, theorizes that the reason people went so wild over this is that because Britney is a real person, it's damaging to both Britney and fans with her body type to change a real human being's body shape to something more stereotypically sexy. She also mentioned that it could be because she included her original reference picture in the video, which is effectively putting a stylized interpretation of Britney right next to the real Britney, and subsequently making the comparison between the two a lot more dramatic and harder to ignore. I agree with that completely and personally believe that if she hadn't and that comparison wasn't right there and readily showing everyone how much smaller the waist was, this wouldn't have blown up so much. But the underlying problem remains that stylizing art by exaggerating features shouldn't be demonized regardless of the way it's presented. But we'll get there, just wait. Anyway, Jackie goes on to explain two key points that I think really exemplify why people were wrong to judge her for this. And the first is that everything about her Britney art was stylized. The face, the hips, the chest, it was all exaggerated and cartoonish because that was the style that she wanted to use. She confirms that her intention had never been to draw a realistic depiction of Britney, but to interpret her in her own way. So for people to go after her for one unrealistic feature in a piece full of unrealistic features, because it being unrealistic is literally the point, seems more than unreasonable. The second point was that this wasn't work for her. Her actual 9-to-5 job is as a character designer, and she acknowledged that if all of her real character design work reflected those unrealistic proportions, it could be legitimately damaging to representation of body diversity. But this was a piece that she literally just sat down and did for fun on her own time, for her to enjoy and for no reason other than that, and people were acting like she was failing some duty or obligation to represent all body types realistically in all of her work. As if artists have some inherent responsibility to provide equal and adequate representation of every trait and type of person constantly, like that's their job even when they're just doing personal work. And that argument is going to be a major focus of this video, because I think there's a lot to discuss there. Before I move into that though, let me just conclude that introduction by saying that I am 100% in Jackie's corner, and I don't believe that she did anything wrong by drawing personal fan art in a stylized manner. I honestly think it's pretty ridiculous that that's in any way a controversial take, but here we are. I'll leave her social media in the description, so please go show her some support. I'm sure this isn't easy. Anyway, while I personally think this drama was a bunch of kids losing their shit over something irrelevant, yet again, and failing to see how much senseless harm they were doing to an artist who had nothing but good intentions, I also recognize that it brought up some real questions that I think are very much worth discussing on the topic of art style and body type diversity. One of the things Jackie said that people were telling her was that if her art style couldn't accurately depict all body types, then her art style is bad and she's not a good artist. Now, obviously this is an incredibly extreme blanket statement, but the basis of it does have some validity. Art styles should be able to reflect traits of all body types, and a failure to do that does often mean that that artist needs to work on improving their ability to diversify their anatomy while still maintaining their style. I can actually agree on this point, honestly, because I feel like a lot of artists out there are using style as an excuse to only ever draw Barbie-esque body types and nothing else. And if that's all they want to draw and they acknowledge that, that's one thing, I guess. But I can see where people are coming from when they express discontent with artists like that drawing real people or even established characters that actually have bigger frames and still only drawing them with perfect skinny hourglass figures. I think erasing a real person or established character's body type can be damaging, even if it is only that artist's personal fan art, because bigger characters and people already get so little representation or acceptance in media that having them reduced to society's caricature of acceptable beauty in art is straight up insulting. It also sends the message that the character or person wasn't beautiful enough with their actual body type, so it had to be changed to fit a more mainstream vision of beauty, which does hurt people. That said, in Jackie's situation, I don't think that even slightly applies. As Ethan mentioned in his video, it would have been another issue entirely if she had drawn someone like Lizzo, who is big, beautiful, and rightfully proud of it, in the way that she drew Britney. That wouldn't have been just interpreting Lizzo in her own exaggerated style. It would have been erasing and replacing Lizzo's actual body type. But Britney Spears actually is a thin woman with an hourglass figure, and exaggerating that figure for stylistic purposes isn't erasing anything. And that's where I feel like a lot of people have consistently been misunderstanding this issue. Because in the case of artists taking bigger characters or people and drawing them thin, there's an actual problem, and that is not art style, that is erasure. But in the case of artists taking characters or people that are actually thin and drawing them with exaggerated features that are in line with that, that's not a problem, and that really is just art style. But the other thing I wanted to talk about here is the problematic expectation that all artists, hobbyists, and professionals alike should be obligated to provide equal and diverse representation of all body types in their work. Because I think that expectation is one of the main motivators for the toxicity that led to Jackie's unwarranted TikTok canceling. Like, the fact that this artist had to say, "I feel like I should be able to draw what I want, how I want to draw it, on my personal time," as if that was a controversial opinion, breaks my heart. And it speaks volumes to the problem that this has become in the community. To be clear, I personally believe that professional character designers and illustrators do have a responsibility to provide equal representation of body diversity throughout their work. Artists in their position are literally the deciding factor as to whether or not bigger audiences get representation or not, and they should be held to a higher standard with that than just artists drawing on their own independent personal time. Because it actually affects people other than them, and it shouldn't be up to their preference as to what they like to draw. For example, I don't think I have an obligation to be constantly drawing diverse body types in my own personal work. But I absolutely did and do when it comes to designing the cast of characters I'll be including in the webcomic I'm developing, because one reflects my personal preferences and comfort zone, and one actually has the potential to give bigger readers representation in a piece of media they might enjoy or identify with. But I don't think audiences have absolutely any right to tell hobbyist artists, or even professional artists doing hobby work, that they can't draw what they enjoy if they don't provide accurate, realistic, and diverse body type representation. Artists are not obligated to make their personal work fit literally any kind of criteria that their audience decides to apply to it. It is not their job to draw what anyone wants to see, or how they want to see it, because it's not their job at all. People are just straight up policing artists' personal hobby work. You don't get to tell artists what body types to draw or how they're allowed to depict them in their style unless, in my opinion, they're erasing an established character or individual's actual real-ass body. Not exaggerating their existing features, but replacing their existing features with those of an entirely different body type. In fairness, I'm not overweight, and I never have been, so I realize I may not be in a position to make that kind of a statement. I am, however, currently underweight due to health problems, and the only representation I personally see for my body type tends to be characters who are intended to appear sickly, diseased, or weak. That doesn't mean I'm out there scouring the streets of Twitter, screaming at artists who draw underweight characters exaggerated in their style with slightly more curves, or less of their bones showing, or more of their bones showing, or even appearing to be an average weight, or deathly ill, because all of that is pretty typical of someone interpreting that character within a reasonable, plausible range of exaggeration and stylization. It genuinely bothers me that people are actually actively saying that if you don't draw a character or person's body type exactly how it is, you're erasing body diversity and hurting people everywhere. Not only is that untrue and hurtful, it has the potential to be detrimental in a very real way to exaggerated art styles. There was a point in Ethan's interview where Jackie basically just said, like, "What do they want me to do? Should I just start drawing realistically?" And that really, really upset me on her behalf, because no, absolutely not. Her style is exaggerated, and that's a super cool, appealing, and unique aspect of her work that should not be erased and forced to conform to realism, because it doesn't perfectly depict a realistic human body. And this increasing animosity towards artists who exaggerate physical features truly threatens to erase the individuality of art styles that were never actually hurting anyone to begin with. And to be absolutely 100% clear, I do understand where people are coming from when they're upset by art that depicts people or characters as thinner than they actually are, even if it is just that artist's personal work and a reasonable depiction within their style. I have body image issues, like I know a lot of people out there do too, and I can understand and relate to the feelings of invalidation, inadequacy, and self-hatred that can come from being constantly surrounded by media depicting the only beautiful body type as skinny with the exact right amount and type of curves. I know how much it can hurt and how exhausting it can feel to have artists you enjoy depict it the same way, even if it is just the exaggerated features typical of normal stylization. But there comes a point when we have to say, then maybe I shouldn't follow artists that make content that upsets me, rather than artists shouldn't draw content that upsets me. And that line is being crossed way, way too often. But maybe I'm just being insensitive, I don't know. These are just my opinions either way, and I'm really interested to hear what you guys have to say about this, because this is another situation in which a nuanced, complicated issue has become problematic because it was treated as black and white, and the only real way to solve issues like that is to discuss them. So please let me know what you think in the comments below. Do you think exaggerating features is an art style choice or erasure of body diversity? Do you think artists have an obligation to create body diverse content all the time? Am I the asshole here? Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and special shout out as always to channel members Café Soleil, Lotus Dreams Art, and Joseph Solomon. You guys will be getting a compilation video soon of all of my Cutetober time lapses. And if anyone else wants access to that, as well as a bunch of other member-only content, click the card above to learn about my channel memberships and consider joining them. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.